Welcome students to one of the most important sessions in your reading comprehension class. This is, I would by far say, one of the most important sessions simply because this is where I'm going to give you a completely different approach to solve reading comprehension questions. So what I'm trying to achieve with these sessions is to give a mathematical approach, to give you a mathematical approach to solve English RC questions. Okay, that's what I'm trying to help you out with, guys. Okay, it's a very new, very interesting methodology. If you're able to apply it, you'll be very, very successful. Why this is essential, why it is very important. What do we typically do in math questions? The way we solve math question is first, we understand the question. Okay, so what we do is we understand the question. After we understand the question, what do we do? Next step is basically we apply a set of formulas. Okay, we apply formula. Okay, and then we apply the formula and get the answer. Okay, and then we pick the right answer choice. This is a methodology which we follow. Okay, so we understand the question, apply the formula and get the answer and pick the right answer choice. This is how we solve a mathematics question. But if you look at English questions, right, English question is slightly different. Okay, because you have a passage. So typically what happens? The challenges which you face. So if you look at RC questions, right, first it's very difficult to understand the passage. So understanding the passage is a challenge. The next thing is, after we understand the passage, the next thing is we do not know how to formulate the answer. Okay, so first is, suppose let's say you have a very cryptic passage and it becomes very, very challenging to understand the passage. Okay, let's assume you've understood the passage. It's very difficult to formulate the answer. So most of the times, what do? We look at the answer choices and try to formulate the answer. Or we are trying to guess the answer from the answer choice. Now go back to your mathematic question, right? Any math question. We never look at the answer choice and guess what the answer is. Typically, we try to solve it and then pick the right answer choice. And then the final challenge with respect to RC is you have very tricky answer choices. These are three problems. These are the major issues which you face with respect to RCs. And these are the typical three problems I've seen with all my students. Okay, understanding the passage, formulating the answer is very tricky, and the answer choices are pretty close. Okay, so what we discussed was, okay, fine. Understanding the passage is a challenge. Okay, that is why we have the reading principles class. Okay, the reading principles class basically helps you to understand the passage. Okay, it helps you to figure out what is really very important while answering the question. The objective of this particular session, the reading principles class, was to pick up that 20% of the passage. The whole idea was to pick up 20% of the passage, which will help us to answer 80% of the questions. Now that we know that, okay, fair enough, we know that this 20% is going to help us answer 80% of the questions. Now we need to formulate the answer, and then we need to find out whenever we're stuck between two answer choices, how do I pick the right answer choice? How do you eliminate all these tricky answer choices and pick the right one? To achieve these two is what I have my RC rules class. And the way I've modeled this entire session is very similar, or it is very similar to the way you solve mathematics question. Okay, so if I look at a math question, right, what do you do? So math question, first you categorize the question, right? Okay, so you categorize the question. What do you mean by categorize the question? Okay, you will first identify whether it's an algebra question or an arithmetic question, okay, or it is a geometry question, be let's say permutation and combination. Before you apply the formula, right, you should know what formula to apply. For that, you need to categorize. So step one is, you'll always, what do you typically do in math questions? So step one, you categorize the question. After you categorize the question, what do you do? Step two, you apply the formula and you get the answer. These are two steps you will follow in any mathematics question. You will apply the formula and you will get the answer. You don't do anything beyond this. Okay, categorize, apply the formula. Very similar process we're going to do in RCs. Okay, so first thing is, before we start answering the different types of questions, etc., I'll explain the process which you are following. What is the process I am trying to follow for solving English questions or RC questions? So again, it's a three-step process. Step one, I will teach you how to categorize the question. Step two, formulate the answer. Okay, I want you to formulate the answer choice. So I don't want you to guess what the answer is. Step three is an additional step compared to mathematics. See, in mathematics, you have step one and step two. Categorize, apply the formula, you'll get the answer. And there'll be one answer choice. You don't have to eliminate any answer choice at all. You don't have to eliminate any answer choice. There won't be any tricky answers. You apply the formula properly, you will get the answer. So there's no concept of getting stuck between two answer choices. So here, Okay, you'll never have this choice at all. You'll always pick the right answer choice. Either you'll get the wrong, either you'll pick the right answer choice, or there'll be a trap which will be laid and you'll pick the wrong answer. But in RCs, we have one step further. You categorize, you formulate. After that, okay, how do you eliminate the traps? Okay, how do you eliminate all the traps? Okay, this is a three-step process which I'm going to follow while solving RC questions. So first, I'm going to categorize. Next, I'm going to formulate the answer. For every category, I'm going to give you an algorithm or a working methodology. Okay, I'm going to give you an algorithm or a working methodology to answer the question. And then eliminate the traps. How do we eliminate the traps? We will use the rules. The rules are basically the do's/don'ts. Okay, so these are three steps, and I'll teach you some categorization process also. If I have to categorize, I should know what are the different categories of questions in English RCs. Okay, the first thing I'm going to teach you is what are the different types of questions in RCs. So let's start with that. There are fundamentally six types of questions in RCs. The first category is called as the main theme question. The second one is called as database question. The third category is called as structure questions. The fourth one is called as tone questions. The fifth one is called as inference. And the sixth one is called as hypothetical questions. These are six important types of questions in RCs. You just have to remember six categories. That's it. These first four categories is what I call as my low-hanging fruits. Now, why do I call them as low-hanging fruits? Because they are very easy to solve. They are really easy to solve. For many of these questions, you don't even have to understand the passage and you'll get the answer. Most importantly, I will teach you how to verify the answer after you've picked the answer. Let's assume without using any rules also, I'm okay with it. You use your instinct to pick the answer and you're not sure whether the answer is right. I'll give you some methodologies to verify the answer using some interesting principles. That's why these are low-hanging fruits. These are questions you must attempt at any cost. The first category we're going to look at is our main theme questions. So let's follow the three-step process here. Step one is we should know how to categorize, or how do I identify that this question is a main theme question. Okay, so let me give you some indicators. Okay, so moment you see the following words, right, you can be pretty sure that this is a main theme question. So what are the indicators? Okay, what are some keywords, indicators/keywords, okay, which will help us to identify that this question is a main theme question. So what are those keywords? So first one would be, okay, what is the primary purpose of the passage? Okay, that's one way they'll ask this question. Then they'll ask you, what is the main theme of this passage? What is the main theme? What is the gist? What is the summary of this particular passage? The third thing you will see is, okay, what is the author's primary conclusion of this particular passage? Which of the following statements will the author strongly support? Then what is the key idea of this particular passage? So main theme questions are basically summary of the passage questions. It's like summary or gist of the entire passage. Now I know that it is a main theme question. Okay, now we know clearly it's a main theme question. What is step two? We need to formulate the answer. So what is the algorithm or the working methodology for answering this question? Let's see that now. What that is step two. The good thing about this question is that you don't even have to understand the passage. Let's put it like this. You don't have to really understand the passage to find out what the main theme is. Now this is an ironic situation, right? Main theme is like, what's your key idea of the entire passage? What is the author trying to convey finally? I'm saying that, look, you don't even have to understand the passage, but still you can identify the main theme. Now we are making a mockery of the entire examination paper. But anyway, that's why we are here. Okay, we are trying to find some interesting crooked ways of getting the answer. So we will do that. The beauty of this question is you can find the answer in four important lines. The four places where you can find the answer for these questions are first paragraph, first line, first paragraph, last line, second paragraph, first line, last paragraph, last line. Only these four places. You can find the answer for these questions in four important lines. First paragraph, last line, second paragraph, first line, last paragraph, last line. Now, I know these four important lines. These are the four important lines. From these four lines, I will teach you what are the two most important lines. Now, you're making a complete joke of the passage. Huh? You're saying that, okay, first I said you don't even understand the passage. You can find the answer in four lines. From those four lines, I will tell you which are the two most important lines. Okay, so pretty simple, guys. The way we identify the two most important lines is like this. If the geography of the first paragraph, we know what is geography. We saw that in the last session. If the geography or summary of the first paragraph does not match with the geography or summary of the last paragraph, the first paragraph is basically giving you background information. Now, I'm being very diplomatic here, guys. When I say it is giving background information, what I'm actually trying to tell you is that the first paragraph is useless. I'm just being very diplomatic because the author has taken some pain to write that paragraph. But to be very honest, if the geography of first paragraph doesn't match with geography of last paragraph, I know clearly the first paragraph is useless. Therefore, what are the most important lines? Just go back, right? If I know the first paragraph is useless, so what are the two most important lines? The two most important lines are going to be second paragraph, first line, last paragraph, last line. And if the geography matches, your first paragraph is very important. If the geography of first paragraph matches with geography of last paragraph, the first paragraph is very important. Therefore, the most important lines are going to be first paragraph, first line, first paragraph, last line. Okay, it's the first paragraph, first line, first paragraph, last line. Simple, guys. Let's move on to step three. How do I find out the most important lines between these two lines? So first I told you four lines. From four lines, we went to two lines. Okay, and from four, two, we'll go to one. So four to two, two to one. How do you identify the most important line? That is your step three. Typically, the main theme lines will have structure words. Okay, typically, main theme lines will have structure words. So you're stuck between two lines. I don't know which is the most important line. I will look at which, I will find out which line has a structure word, and that will be the most important line. Just keep that in mind. Main theme lines will have structure words. Structure words is what we discussed last class. Okay, what are the structure words? Let me give you an example of structure words. Examples of structure words would be therefore, thus, however, on the other hand, but, nevertheless, moreover. Okay, all these are very important structure words.